What's up, YouTube? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Abby Kumar, and in today's video, we are going to be customizing our iPhones with the new iOS 14 update. Now, if you have been on the internet at all this past week, then you've heard about this update and you've probably seen a few videos. So I'm gonna share with you how I did my screen, how I customized my screen to have it aesthetically pleasing, but I'm gonna add a little spin on it just to make it a little bit different from what you've been seeing. I'm going to show you how you can customize it to your branding and still use the icons, the logos of the apps. It'll probably make more sense if I just jump on my phone and show you what I'm talking about. So for me, I'm very visual, and the way I can find the apps on my phone very quickly is by their logo. So if I'm wanting to get on Instagram, I know what the Instagram logo looks like. But I still wanted to customize my iPhone and have it to my brand colors. Now, if you're an entrepreneur like me, then you've probably spent a great deal of time figuring out what your brand is and your brand colors, and you probably want to use it wherever possible. If you're not an entrepreneur, that's fine. This video is still going to be helpful to you if you want to still use logos but have them be in your colors, that you, the colors that you find aesthetically pleasing. So if you want to learn how to do that, I'm going to show you in this video. What I actually use is the free online software Canva. You can go on there and create all types of graphics and videos. So I'm going to show you how I created these icons on there. And what I'll actually do is I'll include a free download below where you can get this template that I created and use it for your own iPhone. But you just, you know, change it to the colors that match your aesthetics and your brand. The first step, you want to make sure that you have your iPhone updated. And to do that, you just go into your settings and you go to general software update. And if your software is not up to date on your phone, it will tell you right there that you can download and install it. If it is, then it'll show you a screen that everything is up to date. Now, you cannot do these customizations I'm going to show you until you have the new iOS 14 on your phone. So then the next thing I would recommend that you do is to just go ahead and make a list of the apps that you want on your home screen. I just wanted to have 8 apps total, even though I could have probably filled it up and probably have several pages. I just wanted to have 8 apps that I use the most, and I wanted to also leave space for widgets, and I'll show you the widgets later in the video. So yeah, make a list of the apps that you want to include on your home screen, so that way it's going to be easier when you go in to make it. You already have a list of what you need. So the next thing that you need to do is go ahead and gather your graphics, and this is going to be for your wallpaper, the icons that we're going to be customizing or adding shortcuts rather on your phone, and also if you want to include any photos in your widgets. So there are a couple ways that you can do this. Now, the easiest way, and the way you've probably seen all around the internet, is just go on Google, Twitter, Pinterest, and search what you're looking for. You can even go on Pinterest, say your aesthetic or your color that you want to use is brown. You can go on Pinterest and search brown aesthetic, and you'll get a bunch of photos that you can just download and use as your background, or you can use them as your icon. So that's gonna be the easiest, quickest way to get it done. Now, the way I'm gonna show you on my computer is how you can do it on Canva. And Canva is a free online app that you can use, and it doesn't cost any money to use it unless you want to upgrade to the pro version. And the pro version just gives you pretty much more graphics and more features. And before you jump on Canva, you do need to create an account. So I'll include a link for Canva below if you want to go ahead and create your account. Like I said, it's free, but you have the option to upgrade. Yeah, let's just go ahead and jump right into my computer so I can show you how to create these icons and how to get them on your phone and customize it to your branding. All right, so welcome to my computer screen. So I'm gonna show you how to create your custom wallpaper and also how to create the icons that we'll use on your homepage. So you'll need to get onto canva.com, and I've included some links below for it as well. Once you're in Canva, if you don't have an account, you'll need to create one. It's free. Once you have an account created, you go here to create a design. Here I had already started searching. They do have templates already, like pre-made templates, so if you want to do a phone wallpaper, they already have the dimensions there for you. So select that, and then it'll give you a blank canvas that you can work on. So on the side here, they have different templates that you can use, design templates, or you can just create your own. And what I like to do is I know I want to use a photo background, so I like to go here to elements and actually put in a photo grid. That way the photo that I choose just automatically snaps in there. So to search for the photo you want to use, you can either upload your own picture or you can search their database of photos. So I'm going to search theirs, and the one I recently used was this one, and that's one I do plan to use as well. And for this, what I did was I just searched textured, and it gave me a bunch of different textures, but I knew I wanted to use this. So see, once If you have that photo grid, you can just snap it right into place. So let me show you why I like to use that photo grid first. So let's say we're doing a new page and you just want to use this picture as the background. Without that photo grid, all you have to do is just stretch it out to the size that you want. And it's just a second more, but it's a little faster if you use the photo grid. And so for me, I like this texture, but I don't like this color. Since it's a picture, it doesn't allow you to change the color. So I go and I add just a box over it with the color that I want it to be. To change the color, you select this box right here. And as you can see on mine, I have Canva Pro, so I already have my brand colors up here. And I want it to be this light color. So I'm just going to put that box over the texture, and I'm going to lower the transparency so that way it's more blue. So see how it's gray here, but putting that blue box over has made it a little bit more to my brand. And that's it. That's the wallpaper I'm going to use. When you're ready to download it, you just select download. And then you just select the page that you actually want to download, and then done, and it will download it and save it. So for the icons, you just go here, create a new design, and what you want is for it to be a square. An Instagram post is a square, or a logo is a square, or you can just go to custom dimensions and write in, you know, something like 300 by 300 pixels, or you can do 1 inch by 1 inch. And show you what it looks like. So this is how you do custom dimensions. Yeah, you can just go ahead and select something that's already pre-made to a square. So I'm gonna do logo since it's smaller. So once you have your blank canvas up, you are going to want to select the color that you want your icon to be, like the background color. So I know I want mine to be this dark teal color. And I also did some that are this color as well, but I'll show you what it looks like with the teal color. So once you have your background, you can go ahead and search here for the icons, and you can just go into elements, and as you start searching, it will just pop up. And one thing you need to be mindful of is that there are free graphics and also ones that are included in Pro. So all of these are free, but see, this one is Pro. These are free. So one thing you can do is you can just go here and filter it to just free, apply filter, so that way you only get the free ones. Because what will happen is if you select the ones that are Pro and you don't have a Pro account, once you're ready to download it, it'll ask you if you want to pay for it. If you have a free account, just go ahead and filter. That would be the easiest. And then once you have your icon, you can go ahead and change the color, same box up here, and I want mine to be this light tan color. That's what I'm going to use for all of the icons, all of the logos. So you can just copy that, or you can just add a new page, and here it'll give you some recommendations. So it's thinking, oh, if you're using Instagram, maybe you want to use a Facebook logo. These are both free, so let's use the Facebook one. And when I stretch it out, I like to just keep it within the margins. And if you want it to be centered, an easy way to do that is just go to position and see it's already centered. But you can also use these guidelines that Canva gives you. Let's say it was over here and you want it to be centered in the middle. You just go here to center and then middle. So we'll go to add a new page, and let's go ahead and do Twitter. Use the same background. Let's see, what's one more that we can do? Let's do one that's not social media. Say you want to do Google Maps. So it's going to give you all the options there. And these ones, I don't think you can change the color. But if you look at something like this, as long as these squares pop up, then you can change the color. And see, it's giving you some recommendations here. There you go. So you can select your colors however you want it to be. Yeah, you just search through for all of the icons that you want to use, the ones that you made a list of. And most of them are there, but there's some that aren't. So one other app that I use is Notion, and Notion is not included in here. It's not that popular of an app, I guess. What I did was I just went into search, and then I just searched an N, since the Notion logo is pretty much an N anyway. So once I do that, all the N's pop up, and I like this one. So once you've created all of your icons, you can just go here to download, same as before. And if you want to download all of the icons that you created, or all of the graphics you created within that file, you can just select all and download them. Once you hit done, it will actually save as a zip file. And to access the photos you created, you just unzip that file, unzip that folder, open it up, and you'll see everything is here. You can select all of the photos and then go to share and airdrop, and that will send it straight to your phone.
Okay, so now onto the phone. We are first going to set up the wallpaper. And to do this, the easiest way is if you just go into your photos and then choose select up at the top right. Then at the bottom left, select the share icon and then just select use as wallpaper. Hit set, set as home screen. Another way that you can do this is just by going into your settings and then to wallpaper, and then you can set it from there. Now to do the icons, you just need to clear out your home screen of all of the unwanted apps. And what we're going to do is open up shortcuts and then hit the plus sign to add a new shortcut, then add action and then open app. And then you just go ahead and choose the app that you want it to open, name the shortcut, and then once you've had it created, you hit the blue dots, select add to home screen. To change the actual photo or the icon, you just click on the icon and then select the photo that you'd like to use and then hit done. And it will just go ahead and add it to your home screen. And you can do this for all of your apps. Okay, now on to adding widgets. What I used is an app called Widgetsmith, and you can just go into the app store, download it, and then open it up. You get an option to choose from a small, medium, or large widget, and I'm doing a medium widget for the calendar. So once you select that, you get to actually choose the style, the font, the tint color, which is just the text color, and the background color. You can go ahead and just create all of your widgets right there, whether you want it to be small, medium, or large. And once you create that, just go back to your home screen. You can slide left and you can search Widgetsmith and then just choose either a small, medium, or large widget that you want to add onto your home screen. I actually put a small slideshow or just an album actually that I created in my photos, and also one small photo widget where I just put a quote. So yeah, you just repeat these for the widgets and then just go ahead and add them to your screen. And then to edit the widget, you just want to go ahead and long press on it. And once it starts moving around, you can go ahead and select edit widget. And then you can just choose the widget that you want. You actually have to actually hit widget again, just so you can see your list of the widgets that you created. And then you can select the one that you want and it will show up on your home screen. And after that, you just go ahead and rearrange your icons on the home screen to how you want it to look. So if you don't want your other pages that are unorganized to show, all you need to do is actually do another long press on the home screen, select the dots at the bottom, deselect all the ones that you do not want to show up, so just uncheck them, and then they will be hidden. Now, one other feature I can go over with you is the app library. So once you've hidden all of those pages and you just have your home screen, if you slide to the right, then you will see your app library, and it'll have all your apps there. And whether if you don't see it pop up right away, you can search it or just go ahead and look it up alphabetically there on the side.
But yeah, that's it for this video, guys. I hope that you enjoyed it, and if you did like it or found it useful at all, please go ahead and give this video a thumbs up, share it with a friend. And if you want to see more of my videos, be sure to subscribe. I recently just uploaded a video where I unboxed my iPad 8th generation, so you can check that out too. I'm going to be customizing it similarly to this, so maybe I'll do a video on that next. And also, don't forget that I do have the template below where you can download it, or you can easily just go on Canva just like I showed you and create it yourself. But I really do hope that you stick around, and I'll catch you next time. Bye.